Devised a number of very ingenious weapons in their struggle against the forces of nature. Forces of nature. Deadly bacteria. Tetanus. Lockjaw. Bacillus Welchi. Gangrene. Streptococcus. Poisoner. Crippler. Killer. Staphylococcus, distiller of pus from living tissue. Invisible presence on the surface of the skin, keen for an open wound, eager to enter, to befoul the blood of a man. Preparing for an operation? These men oppose with their feeble minds and hands the irresistible forces of nature. They perform a foolish ritual. They burden themselves with a ponderous chain of asepsis, linking every man in surgery in a pompous ceremony of sterile hocus-pocus. But men are frail, so very frail. One link is always weak. We'll find that link. Break it. Your hands won't really be sterile if you scrub the full 10 minutes. There are always a few germs left, no matter how long you scrub. Oh, well. Of course, if you enjoy this form of exercise, it's entirely up to you. Impossible. You men are impossible. Forever scrubbing, 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 scrubbing. Don't you ever stop? Isn't there even a single one of you who...
Well, come in. Happy to see you. You're late. Better late than early. But you'll have time to scrub. You can go through the motions and finish with the rest. After. You can get by once without scrubbing the full 10 minutes. What are a few thousand germs more or less? All right, you're finished. That's right. You can knock off now. You've scrubbed enough. See, you've scrubbed 2 minutes. 2 entire minutes. Very well. Give it a last lick.
There's no harm in exercising your hide a little more. There's still time. But it's just as well that you don't see the spectacle created by this incessant rubbing and scrubbing of the skin, its hairs and tiny scales, dislodging the microscopic bacteria, Staphylococci. Deadly and invisible.
don't let habit get the better of you. Minutes all together. Hurry up, they're waiting for you. That's a sensible fellow. Why be a slave to a routine? Wait a minute. What's this? Feel a sneeze coming on? Relax. Everything will be all right. That does it. Out of the throat and nose, streptococcus.
You're trying to get us brushed off. Scram out of here.
Yeah, quit your beef. Nothing's gonna happen.
That won't be necessary. You're gonna wear gloves, aren't you? That's right. Get in there now. Oh, come on. Come on. Now we must garb him in the proper costume. Oh, yes, adjust his mask. He might sneeze suddenly. And be careful not to touch his sterile lily-white gown. Bacteria, you know. By all means, some powder. Makes the gloves slip on easily. That will keep the little fellow safe for a while.
I thought you said nothing was gonna happen.
Oh, so you're the instrument man. Well. And here's our patient. Did you cut your glove? Discard the instrument that you've contaminated. Don't sterilize them all. There isn't time. One of those. Well, one of these. Come on, take one. All right, you choose. Fine. Discard that one. Excellent choice. But we'll take this one. The chain is broken. What a lovely comedy. Tedious hours of scrubbing. Equipment, instruments sterilized. Endless field days. Even the air is filtered. Study, training, research, pretentious hospital. Millions of dollars. Lifetimes of service. Lister, Pasteur, Harvey, Vesalius, Hippocrates. The whole tradition of man's struggle against disease. Blasted by one fumbling corner. Why do you hesitate?
your surgical conscience bothering you? Don't let it worry you too much. It's too late to back out now. It would be quite embarrassing, wouldn't it, to admit the reason, your petty theft of time. Go on, pass the retractor, the one that's contaminated. Feeling a little better? How's the leg? Well, just a few days more now, and we'll know a great deal more.
Everything's fine. From the outside.
If the eye, the blind eye of a man, could plumb the flesh, penetrate the skin and fat and muscle, approach the bone, he would see in the depths of the new incision a pool of plasma and a clot of blood. Red corpuscles, millions, shriveled up, lashed together with strands of fibrin. Warm, dark, a delightful retreat for microbes. Excellent climate. No prying leukocytes, plenty of fresh, warm plasma. That's what he likes, plasma.
Moving with the plasma out to the living flesh. boy. Ain't this swell? Ain't it swell? Whee!
Here comes the first of the defectors, working through the capillary wall, moving through the tissue, leukocytes.
Hold your poison.
Devour them and die. You're headed for the pus pile, leukocytes. Beginning of an abscess. Streptococcus, remember? Chains of thousands of chains growing into a capillary, plugged with some clotted blood. Into the capillary, into the bloodstream. Doesn't the patient look fine? Temperature is normal. Combined operation. Beautiful work, staff. A very fine start. Streptococcus septicemia. Streptococcus septicemia. No change? Millions of leukocytes poisoned and piling up. Technique, was it, Doctor? The linen? Was the linen sterile? The skin prep? The sutures? The instrument? Maybe it was one of the instruments. Was it your fault, Doctor? Doctor, is your crew dependable?
get the cane. You're going to need it for the rest of your life.